Roses are red, violets are blue, and bananas are red too? The typical yellow banana you use for your morning smoothie is just one type of this exquisite fruit. Turns out there are more than 1,000 different kinds of bananas. And the color isn't the only variant.
Ooh, banana.
There are savory ones and even ones that taste like ice cream, without all the calories and added sugar. Isn't that a dream come true? But if there are so many bananas, why have you eaten the same yellow one your whole life? What are some of the other varieties of bananas? And why is the banana's future threatened? Go and get a banana, and we'll have the answers in a split second. Bananas are a breakfast staple. They're an easy snack and an important source of potassium. But this berry, and yes, bananas are berries, has a long history under its peel. This fruit's origins go back about 10,000 years in Indonesia, the Philippines, and New Guinea. Explorers and traders liked bananas so much that they took them back to India and Africa. From the 5th to the 15th centuries, traders brought banana suckers from Arabia, Persia, and India to the rest of the world. The word banana derives from banan, an Arabic word that means finger. But this ancient banana had a woodier taste, a lot of seeds, and it didn't have much delicious pulp. Speaking of flavors, let's look at some varieties of this fruit that I bet you've never heard about. Meet the ladyfinger, a smaller banana 10 to 12.5 centimeters long. It has a pale yellow peel, and it's very sweet. Next, we have the blue Java bananas. They're also called ice cream bananas because, well, they taste just like vanilla ice cream.
That is really good.
Would you find a black banana appealing? Manzano, or apple banana skins, turns black when they're ripe. These small, round bananas have a flavor similar to apple and strawberry. These pretty pink-fleshed fruits are called red bananas. Then there are goldfinger bananas. They're a newer type that tastes kind of like apples. The praying hands variety looks exactly like that, with its hands growing so closely. And you'll be praying to taste its delightful vanilla flavor. Your everyday yellow banana is the Cavendish, named after the 6th Duke of Devonshire in England. He was so bananas for this fruit that he brought plants from China in the 1820s and cultivated them in his greenhouse. The Duke saw the potential in this fruit and shipped some to other countries. It was a hit. By the 1900s, the Cavendish banana was among the most popular varieties in the whole world. But one type of banana was more popular, the Gros Michel, or Big Mike. Producers overgrew the plants until, sadly, it developed a pathogen known as Race 1. The virus nearly wiped out the Gros Michel. Luckily, the Cavendish wasn't as vulnerable to the pathogen. By the 1950s, the Cavendish was the king of the banana market. You might think the industry has learned from its mistake, but it hasn't. In 2014, farmers in Jordan and Mozambique found strange growths in their crops' roots. It's a new strain of that old pathogen. It's named Tropical Race 4, and it looks like it's on the move, threatening Cavendish bananas. But red bananas aren't the only fruit you've never eaten, unless you have eaten them, in which case, again, ignore me. There are many crazy fruits. Some you have to peel, and some you have to get past a bad smell to get to the good stuff. Would you be able to eat the stinkiest fruit ever? Find out on another episode of Origins of Food.